sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. Came from heaven to earth to show the way.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father, the love of our life-giving Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, in today's gospel, the Lord Jesus speaks to us of true happiness. He shows us and he teaches us how to be truly happy. So that we might follow the Lord's gifts to us, let us begin this Mass by first calling to mind our sins and then asking the Lord for his divine mercy. Lord, for the times we have failed to follow your path to happiness, Lord, have mercy. Christ, for the times that we have sought our own will rather than your divine will, Christ, have mercy. And Lord, for the times that we have not followed your example and your teaching, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins, and may he bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who made St. Peter Claver a slave of slaves and strengthened him with wonderful charity and patience as he came to their help, grant through his intercession that seeking the things of Jesus Christ, we may love our neighbor in deeds and in truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord be with you. Our gospel reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Raising his eyes towards his disciples, Jesus said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for the kingdom of God is yours. Blessed are you who are now hungry, for you will be satisfied. Blessed are you who are now weeping, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude and insult you, and denounce your name as evil on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice and leap for joy on that day. Behold, your reward will be great in heaven. For their ancestor treated the prophets in just the same way. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. But woe to you who are filled now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who laugh now, for you will grieve and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for their ancestors treated the false prophets in just this way." The Gospel of the Lord. Everyone, in today's Gospel, Christ Jesus tells us how to be happy. We take the teachings that Jesus just gave us and we call them Beatitudes. Now, Beatitudes does not really come from an English word or from a Paduta word.
It actually comes from the Latin word beatus, which means happiness. So what Jesus is teaching us in today's gospel is how to be truly happy. Gang, I think a lot of the times you'll find we feel the deepest, lasting happiness when we do something good for someone else. That gives us that feeling of giving God's goodness to someone else. That gives us that feeling of very important in God's plan. So, this is kind of a difficult question. You may need to think on it a while, okay? What I need you to do now is to think. Figure out a time when you did something good for someone else, okay? What I need you to do is stop and think and figure out a time when you did something good for someone else. And then after that, how did you feel, okay? If you can pick out a time when you did something good for someone else, then figure out how that made you feel, great. Sweetheart, did you want to start? Go ahead, honey. What is something good that you did for someone else?
When my big sister lost her Nintendo Lite, I helped her find it.
Okay, lost her Nintendo remote?
No.
Her?
Nintendo Lite.
Light? Okay. When her sister lost her Nintendo Lite, guess who helped to find it? Sweetheart, how did you feel when y'all found that Nintendo? You felt happy doing something good for her. Thank you. Sweetheart, can you think of a time when you did something good for someone else?
I helped my sister clean her room.
Helped your sister clean her room. How did you feel after that room was clean?
Good.
You felt good. Wonderful. Anybody else? Honey, can you think of something good that you did for someone else? Helped your dad build a chair that he was making. How did you feel when that chair was finished?
Good.
Wonderful. Good. You felt good. Thank you. Let's see. Honey, can you think of something good that you did for someone else? And stayed with that person. How did you feel once you started walking with them? At camp, the gang was on a hike, but there was one person who was walking very slow and kind of lagging behind everyone else. So what she did was to go and drop back and walk with that person who was all by herself. And of course felt very happy after doing something so nice for someone. Pal, can you think of a time that you did something good for someone else?
I folded towels and cleaned around the house.
Well, so after you finished folding the towels at home and then cleaning around the house, how did you feel?
Good.
Felt good. Great. Y'all, thank you for holding up your hands. You came up with some excellent answers. But gang, what I want you to notice is when we do good for someone else, notice how it makes us feel good. It makes us feel happy. Now that is true happiness. Now, as usual, I forgot to check with the choir. Pal, can you think of something good you did for someone else?
One time I went to the beach and then there was a little kid and like the sand, like his boxes that made the sandcastle was in the water and was about to wash away, but I got it and gave it back, and even though I didn't know him.
Oh, very nice. One time this man went to the beach, and he noticed this one little kid who was building a sandcastle was about to have the bucket he was using to haul the sand. The bucket was about to wash out in the tide. He was going to lose the bucket. But this man actually caught that bucket and saved it and gave it back to the little kid, even though he didn't know who the little fellow was. And of course, that made him feel quite good. Gang, why don't we now offer to Almighty God all of the goodness that we can do unto others and thank Him for giving us those opportunities. If you would, please stand for our prayers and our petitions. Lord, hear our prayers.
Our country and the
world. Lord, hear our prayers.
For our families and the
world. Lord, hear our prayers.
For all teachers, students, and praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Lord, hear our prayers.
For the venerable Peter, Joseph, Carson, Saint of the Great Class,
Lord, hear our prayers. For the special intentions requested for today's Mass of Lynn Miyed and of Kenneth Leary Sr. and family, for our own individual intentions, as well as our personal prayers of thanksgiving, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the many opportunities that you give us to serve others and to share with them your goodness to us. Help us to always live in your happiness upon this earth, so that we might receive the eternal happiness of your heavenly kingdom, as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed to you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed to you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. My brothers and sisters, since these gifts of bread and wine now represent ourselves and our lives, which we offer to God our Father, I ask you to pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your people, and grant that we who celebrate your Son's work of boundless charity, may by the example of blessed St. Peter Claver, be confirmed in love of you and of our neighbor through Christ our Lord. And may the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Peter Claver, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayer. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." If we seek the Lord's gift of true happiness, then let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
We pray,
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint John the Evangelist, Saint Teresa of Avila, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who enables us to find true happiness by doing his divine will. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. If you would take the two sides, please. If you finish before I do, then just come pick up in the back. The body of Christ. Sweetheart. May Almighty God love you and be with you forever. The body of Christ. 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 Sweetheart, right this way. The body of Christ. 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 May Almighty God love you and be with you forever. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May Almighty God love you and be with you forever. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May Almighty God love you and be with you. There, good girl. The body of Christ. Amen. So, honey, put your Jesus in your mouth. Pull your mask down. There you go. Good. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May Almighty God love you and be with you forever. The body of Christ. 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 May Almighty God love you and be with you forever. The body of Christ. 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 Right. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Roger, did you
get both songs?
Okay. For those of you who are viewing at home or in the classroom and are unable to receive the Holy Eucharist sacramentally at this time, I would invite you now to please join me in together praying the prayer of spiritual communion. Most Holy Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. May I never be parted from you. Amen. And let us pray. Having fed upon the delights of the sacrament of salvation, O Lord, we humbly implore your faithful love, that imitating by your grace the charity of blessed Saint Peter Claver, we may also be made partakers with him in glory through Christ our Lord. And may the Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Gin for an answer, a ray of hope in a hopeless world. Who can we turn to? Who is our rescue? There is someone, he's the answer. He's the light and he'll light the way. His name is Jesus. He came to save us. He is the light, 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 the light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. He, light, light, the light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. World is searching for an answer. Heaven's hope in a hopeless world. Who can we turn to? Where is our rescue? There is someone. He's the answer. He's the light and he'll light the way. His name is Jesus. He came to save us. He is the light, 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 the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. Light, light, light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. Oh, whoa. Thank you.